This is boat care on Citra Island, which you probably recognise, and this is the Mayfox, all nice and clean and covered up now. But that wasn't the case yesterday when we took the boat out for a picnic on one of the three desert islands and an afternoon of water skiing. We took with us the Enright family. You may remember Joe Enright, the lead guitarist in Nice Out, where we took him, his wife, Margaret, and the two children. And this is what happened. Now we're going to introduce you to the two Enrights junior, Georgina and Stuart. When we got to our little desert island, whilst we were making camp, the two kids went off down to the seashore to investigate the sea.
Have they got a longer rope? Lily! Look over there, look at that one.
I know.
Sure. She's staying in the water with a safety jacket.
What happened to your mouth?
Who are you taking a picture of me? Jump in and stick away.
Dog over there.
While Margaret got the meal ready, we decided we'd go water skiing, so we got into the ski boat and drove down to the skiing area near the Asri loading station. And Richard went, if that's the phrase, first. Next it was my turn. Thank you.
to.
Out of focus, Mr. Joe turned in quite an impressive performance at skiing. When you're watching this, remember that he hasn't tried to water ski for 8 years.
We won't give you any tight turns or anything till you're used to it.
Welcome aboard, Admiral.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, I enjoyed that.
Jump the brake, it's a nice change. Excuse me.
Ready? Thank you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our afternoon out as much as we did. Now, if you remember the last tape, it had a little piece of old Bahrain on it, some old Arabic buildings filmed on Maharak Island. Well, we've got an old Arabic sea story for you this week. It's an extract from an Arabic television programme, and it shows the pearl divers of Bahrain, because Bahrain has a history of pearl fishing, and apparently they're some of the finest pearls in the world. The divers use no oxygen at all. They just dive down with the air in their lungs, and they pick the oysters off the oyster beds and put them into baskets, and then they take them back to the dhow. And you'll notice that they're attached to the dhow by a rope, and they entwine the rope around their feet. When they're ready to come back to the surface, they twitch the rope with their feet and then hang on as the rope is pulled back to the boat.